around this time of the year, Jesus always asked me, he said, "Ashley, Elizabeth, who do you consider me to be? Who do you say that I am?" And I'll tell you who he is. He is Elohim, the creator. He is Jehovah Jireh, the Lord who provides. He is Jehovah Shalom, the Lord is peace, and our Abba, Father. He is Elohim, my everlasting God. Jehovah Shema, the Lord is there. He is Adonia, my great Lord. And he is El Elyon, my God most high. He is Jehovah Ra, my shepherd. And this Easter, beloved, he is risen. You see, in the beginning of time, God created Adam and Eve. He created them to be perfect and to live in a perfect world. And he gave them dominion over the entire world and all of the animals. He gave them the power to rule, the authority. But with the power to rule comes a great responsibility, and you're expected to rule well, and Adam and Eve did not rule well. The serpent deceived Eve into disobeying God. The one thing he said she could not do, she did. And at that point, the standard to get into heaven was absolute perfection. It's the way God created it to be, and it was the way it stood. But in John 3:16, we learn that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever shall believe in him shall not perish, but will have everlasting life. Meaning that even though the curse of sin had taken place and that heaven was removed from us and it wasn't possible for us to get to heaven anymore and all of us would have gone to hell for this curse, that God made a way because he loved us that much that he had to sacrifice his only Son so that we could have a way to get into heaven. Jesus prophesied that he would have to give his life up on a cross for our sins and the sins of our brothers and sisters. He said that he would be the way, the truth, and the life, and no one would get to heaven but through him. And on this Easter, we celebrate that. We celebrate the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. But there's a missing piece to the puzzle. You see, we know about the death and the resurrection, but we don't know about the gap in between, what those days held and what Jesus had to do in the middle of that. In the Bible, in 1 Peter 3:18-20, it says, "For Christ also hath once suffered for sins, the just for the unjust, and the might bring us to God, being put to death in the flesh, but quickened by the Spirit, by which also he went and preached unto the spirits in prison." Now I want you to look at that for a second. Verse 19, "by which he also went and preached unto the spirits in prison." So at that moment, after his death on the cross, after he took his very last breath, Jesus did not just ascend into heaven. He had to descend into hell. He had to go preach to the spirits that had been cast into hell to proclaim the prophecy that had been fulfilled. In Matthew 16:19, Jesus says, "I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven." You see, in the Bible, when someone has the keys to something, they have the authority. And in the beginning, when God created Adam and Eve, he gave them the keys. He gave them the authority to rule over the earth and all of the animals. But when the curse of sin took place and they disobeyed God, the keys went to hell with that promise. In the book of Romans, it says that if you believe in your heart and you confess with your mouth that Jesus is the Lord, that you will be saved, meaning that you will spend all of eternity in heaven with our Lord Jesus Christ. I pray that you will choose to make that decision today. He is not just a way to heaven, Jesus is the only way to heaven. And I tell you that because I love you and I want you to be in heaven with me for all of eternity. So if you would like to make that decision, I ask that you would pray this prayer with me to make him the Lord of your life. You just simply say, "Dear Lord Jesus, I am a sinner and I need a Savior. I receive your grace today. I believe that you died on the cross for me, and I believe that you rose again. You are the Lord of my life and the one who I will choose to follow all the days of my life. I commit my spirit into your hands, and I receive the salvation that you have. Thank you for your grace, Lord. Your holy, precious, sweet name we pray. Amen." Beloved, if you pray that prayer, I believe that your name is written in the book of life. I believe that you will spend eternity in heaven. Get plugged into a church. Seek godly counsel. Find friends. You don't have to live this life under the oppression of the enemy. He seeks to destroy us. Jesus just didn't die on a cross so that we could get to heaven. He died on a cross so that we could experience heaven here on earth. We don't have to live a day without him. And I pray that this Easter, that will be something that you will consider doing and to do every day for the remainder of the time you have here left on earth. I love you so much, and I hope that your Easter is blessed beyond anything you could ever imagine. You take care, and you be blessed until I see you again.